Yes, mum. We're on our way.
Trust me, it's going to get better. Okay? Gosh. So, thank you for joining us. It's great to be together and share this really hot afternoon. Wearing a suit is not a great idea. But I hope you enjoyed that video. We started off with serious. He's not a fruit of the spirit, but joy is. And I hope today we're going to share some of that joy. I'm out of breath. We're going to share some of that joy with you. As you can see, we're not very serious at times. That's really terrifying doing that. I'm not a natural. Did anyone know this? I take the mickey out of the temples a lot, but flipping out, it's hard work. That was it. Welcome to everyone for joining us this afternoon. It's so fantastic to see so many of you, and I hope you really enjoy this next hour together. I want to make a special welcome to Betty. Betty Baker sat at the front here. She is the most experienced songster in the room. Yeah? The most experienced songster. She's songstered at Burnley Corps and also at St. Samson's Corps on the bridge there. So welcome to you, but welcome to everyone. And I hope you really enjoy this afternoon. So we've got a few things lined up. You'll be pleased to know that we have proper timbrels, okay? So they're done properly, not that nonsense that we just did. Proper timbrels. We've got some small group singers, and of course, we've got a brass quintet later as well. You can't have a Salvation Army concert without any brass, so we've got a brass quintet coming up as well. And of course, the stars of the show, the Songsters. Don't they look good? Don't they look good? Yeah. Hey, there we go. So to start off this afternoon, the Songsters are going to sing a new song that we've learned recently called Adoration, Thanksgiving and Praise. This is a Gowans and Larson song, so those Salvationists will know Gowans and Larson. They wrote loads of musicals back in the 70s, 80s, and they were performed over here. So there's a few people here that may have been involved in the song, in the musicals. Anyone, hands up if you were involved. So some of the older ones, people in the back here. Oh, Meryl, really? Gosh, okay. So a few years ago we performed, and we're going to sing this song. It's the words from a song from the musical Spirit. but it's been set to a new tune. So here's the Songsters with Adoration, Thanksgiving and Praise. On that break, some future Songsters there, I'm sure. Now, during this concert, I thought it'd be great to help you get to know some of the Songsters a little bit better. So I asked them on Wednesday night to share any interesting facts or funny stories or embarrassing stories with me. Sadly, I didn't have a huge take-up, so either they're all very good or they never get into trouble. But we'll kick off with one Songster. I'm not going to tell you who it was. But he admitted to me, that narrative, didn't it? They admitted to me that they had ridden at 106 miles per hour on the back of a motorbike along Bray Road. Which one do you think it is? Which one looks the most guilty? 106 miles per hour. We also got one Songster who confesses that they've been to both the MI5 building in London and also GCHQ, two of the UK security buildings. I'm pretty sure those two things aren't linked, but maybe there's something there I don't know about. So we have a couple more songs from the Songsters which are contrasting. The first one is a modern classic, if you like, and a favourite of one of our retired Songsters who's here today. It's called Singing in the Heavenly Choir. And then following this, we'll have another new song that's been recently learned by the Brigade. It's called He Who Lights the Stars. It's a beautiful piece by William Hastings and Andrew Knight. But first, Singing in the Heavenly Choir.
Yeah.
Some beautiful music we're blessed with. Salvationists, I'm not sure if you know, but Salvationist composers give their music to the Salvation Army. They don't make any money out of it. So all the music the Salvation Army publishes has been given by people who give their time and their talents free to the Salvation Army. And that's fantastic in one of those great songs there. So I have another interesting story for you, and I think this one might be quite easy to work out who it is. I'm not going to give anything away. I'm sure a couple of you might work it out. So one Saturday morning whilst at work, he had a phone call from the chap who organises football refereeing in the islands. Now, excuse me, I'm working now, aren't I? He was at work in the morning and he was asked if he could step in and referee the afternoon match. So he phoned his wife to get his kit ready for him to pick up. And at lunchtime, he popped home, picked up his bag and kit, and went straight to the match to get ready. And on laying out the kit, he discovered he had a black miniskirt instead of his shorts. Now, I'm pretty sure he refereed in that black miniskirt, but he assured me he didn't. Who knows? Any guesses who that was? Eminent referee. Well, popular. Boy the Book. I'm going to give you away. Boy the Book. That was one of his stories. Now, we kicked off this evening with some nonsense from me and a couple of other chaps who tried to do Timbal, so we're going to be showing how to do it properly now by the professionals. The A-team, the elite, the ladies, who are going to show us how to do Timbal properly. They're going to play the cracking march by Eric Silverberg, Heaven Came Down. So here are the real, the proper Timbal. Oh, they're doing that? Okay. Buy some time. A client was telling me earlier this afternoon that Chrissy's changed a bit in there, and she was struggling with remembering to do the new version, so no one's spotted it, I guess I could. Oh, I thought it was fantastic. Well done. Now, one story to share, a couple of stories actually. One songster, whilst in Zimbabwe on holiday, not only came face to face with a lion, but also ended up as a firefighter assistant fighting bushfires. That was in Zimbabwe a few years ago, a lady of many talents. And then she also admitted to me that she went skinny dipping in the pool at Beau Séjour. So firefighting and skinny dipping, so many, many adventures this songster's had. So we're an eclectic bunch. We have a rich array of music in the army and have the heritage of choruses. Chorus songs which have been used throughout the years, and I'd like to invite you to join in with the chorus girls, if they're ready. The chorus girls. Hey, there we go, on cue. And I invite you to join in with the chorus girls, they bring us a selection of army choruses. The words will all be on the screen.
Singing, singing, singing.
to mention, and it's so warm, I think I could do one as well. There's still drinks at the back, so feel free to go up and go and have yourself a drink anytime. If you feel you're going to pass out, like I said, if you only come down, it should be just as light, and it will be good. So just stay comfortable, isn't it? A warm time. It's quite a warm few guys, and they'll lower down there in the next for afternoon. Now, we have a well-travelled bunch of songsters who've been all over the world, and we've had one songster who's actually visited Niagara Falls and flown overhead in a helicopter. I thought you were going to tell me that she was one of those that did the barrel and went over Niagara Falls, because lots of people have done that in the past. No, she's flown over the top of Niagara Falls in a helicopter, so well-travelled and eclectic bunch, actually. We're going to hear from the Songster Brigade again with another two songs. The first one is another new song, an original, by Alan Williams, Saviour, You Are God. And then we will share a classic for the Songster Brigade. It was introduced by Deputy Songster Leader George Waring a few years ago after Malcolm and Enid, who we know very well, Malcolm and Enid Tostevich, were influenced by Oslo Municipal Choir's music. And the second song we will sing is You Are the Light, one of Torart, who's the leader. Be also possible for Christ. So Saviour, You are God and You are the Light.
Thank you.
Yeah. Well, this is a Songster Weekend. It would be unusual in association with other weekends to go without any brass item. So, we've got the cream of the crop from the Songsters, and we're going to have a lower brass quintet. We're going to play. I'm going to waffle for a little bit because they need to get up and start getting ready, but they're not taking the hints. We are going to have a brass quintet. There we go. They're getting ready now. That's great. I need to get out of the way. I'm going to tell you another story. It's a really recent one, actually. So you see Connor over there. You can see his legs now. You can see his legs earlier when we did the Timble display. He was actually wearing the suit trousers. They actually brought Jonathan's. He's a slightly different size, which is why he's wearing Richard's shorts. So that's a little embarrassing story for Connor. Coming very unprepared to wear his suit. Bless him. What embarrassing. To join the video at the beginning, it highlighted joy as a gift of God and that seriousness isn't. And that really resonated with me because Fiona and I, as we try and lead this group, one of the things we're really conscious of is actually there is joy in knowing Jesus, and we are hoping to share some of that with you today. But we try and do that all through the year with every event that the Songsters are involved in. And that segues really nicely into what the brass quintet are going to play. We're going to play a piece arranged by Richard Phillips called Joy, Peace and Happiness. I'll give you the quintet. Go on, Connor. Thank you. Poets played in England is a group called Salvation Brass, and every time we go somewhere, there always happens to be a birthday. Now, this is your birthday here today. Anyone's birthday today? Anyone want to admit it? Oh, it's Emily! Oh, so Emily is 21 today. Oh, sweet. So, now this is literally sight reading, okay? So we're going to all share together a happy birthday to Emily. I printed this out literally 10 minutes before we started. So who knows how it's going to go, but show us as we wish Emily a happy birthday. Sharon's organised all the food, and she's went to the shop, bought it all, and organised all those and helped her to get the catering done. And so the team that should help Sharon as well, especially Lynn, Rosemary, Stephanie, Sandra, and Fiona. A big thank you to those who prepared the hall, so that means bringing all the chairs out of it, getting the tables ready, getting the decorations, John Gallagher, Roy Von Morsu, and Rod. And also all of the Songsters who have taken part. We've been working hard for this weekend, believe it or not, and we're looking forward to sharing tomorrow as well as we leave worship in the morning. And finally, thank you to all of you for coming tonight, this afternoon, because if you weren't here, it would be pretty weird us all stood on the platform singing to know you. So thanks for coming, it's really great. And I just want to add one special thank you to Matt in the back there, he's been running the set. I texted him last night and said help, and he stepped up and he's been running the screen and making sure the mics are on in the right place. Come to an end, I would leave you with the invite for tomorrow morning at 10:30 a.m. here as the Songsters lead worship. You're all very welcome to come and join us. And we're going to sing a couple of songs, the first of traditional Every Time I Feel the Spirit, followed by the whole Songsters singing together. A song that's affectionately become known as the Nappy Song, I've Been Changed. So we will finish this afternoon with the song I've Been Changed, but first, Every Time I Feel the Spirit.